Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the English news from Djibouti channels. Let's begin with the headlines. Djibouti, capital of tourism and African texture, is still going about the CETA. On continental news, in Brazil, on the way to qualifications. That were our headlines. Let's begin with the details. The second day of the international trade fair for African textile, the CETA, namely, the program of the second day, an international conference with a specific theme, industry and craft, was a bridge for an inclusive development of Africa textile in a context marked by the pandemic COVID-19, a reflection which was incurred in a context of COVID-19 pandemic indeed in the face of market changes dedicated by economy and political ambience. Traditional trade is giving way to a market that is now becoming dematerialized. With the closure of borders due to the pandemic, the place of market and trade companies today seek to reposition themselves on their commercial segments through e-commerce in Africa and find ways and means for a growth of the industry. The marketplace no longer being the same, and its former paradigm has found its way into e-commerce. In short interview, the commissioner of the CETA expresses satisfactions of the success of the event. During the press conference made by the representative of African Union, Mrs. Roun Ousmane, said that the International African Textile Exhibitions, namely CETA, relocated for the first time in East Africa. The CETA is a vast market for the promotions and valorizations of African textile, has for several years been intended to participate in the economic development of Africa textile in the different countries. His turn, the Secretary General of the Minister of Commerce, Mr. Ali Daoud, he said also that the objective of the event was to enhance the participation of several actors of the cotton industry, policy makers, as well as the participants. The objective of these discussions and the event it was to propose sustainable solutions for the appropriations of e-commerce for real development of the African economy by increasing the market share of textiles, but also it's play a role to develop a new economic model for economic recovery while supporting the value chain of the sector through the impetus of adequate policies and legal framework in order to create jobs. After the speech, the officials, two panels punctuated the work of the conference, which took place the plenary sessions. The first panel was focused on the African Union fashion industry development and many others. The second theme was the African textile industry market development strategy in the face of the pandemic. In a word hit by the pandemic, the panelists converged on the better inclusion of cotton producer, the development of a new economic model for of economy. With a different speech, the questions and answer sessions was between the different panels and accompanied by experience sharing the idea of updating Africans agenda in function to better revive the economy in this area. The panelists all covered on a very precise recommendation to elaborate a new economic model for the revival of the textile sector. In additions, the discussed between all gathered the participant break the back of the textile industry, precisely the falsification of the design of several manufacturers that flowed Africa in a context of a globalized trade. An evening parade was organized where several personalities were invited to the event. The Minister of Youth and Culture indicated that this fashion show will allow to encourage our young people to position themselves in steel and fashion sustainable solutions for an appropriation of e-commerce for real development of the African economy by increasing the market share of textile. The Minister of Justice, Mr. Ali Hassan Bahdon, received this morning in his cabinet the ambassador of China accredited to Djibouti. The ambassador recalled the importance of Sino-Djibouti cooperation in all aspects, both economy and social, in the development of the Republic of Djibouti. In his discussion, the desire of highlight a partnership project in the judicial field was raised, particularly in the establishment of infrastructure in the field of incarcerations in terms of rehabilitations of civil prisons, but also highlight the project to build court in the interior region as part of the development program of good governance. The Minister of Communication in charge of Post and Telecommunication, Mr. Radwan Abdullahi Bahdon, took part yesterday by video conference the 10th meeting of the Board of Directors of Smart Africa, chaired by the Minister Redwan, and was co-chaired by Redwan and many head of state, such as Paul Kagame. The virtual summit was an opportunity for representative of member countries to review the progress made, but also to discuss the strategic objectives set. The Minister of Health, Mr. Ahmed Rabl Abdullahi, signed a memorandum of understanding with the Port and Free Zone Authority headed by the President, Mr. Abdul Qadir Omar Hadi. The signing of the memorandum of understanding took place between the Minister of Health and the Chairman of the Port and Free Zone Authority, Mr. Abubakar Omar Hadi. The aim is to vaccinate all poor communities and passengers who arrived at the port by setting up two large tents specially designed for this purpose. The objective of the Minister of Health is to vaccinate the maximum number of people on the national territory of visitors who will cross Djibouti in order to better stop the spread of the pandemic. The Secretary General of the Premise, Mr. Naguib Abdullah Kamil, gathered today around the same table the Secretary General of the Ministries at Seni Health Center in Arta. The meeting on the demilitarizations of administration's procedure often present at the keystone of any strategy of modernization of public actions aims to simplify the procedures of users as well as allow easy and fast access of citizens to the administrations in any place of of Djibouti. But also it allows that the state to have accurate and reliable data to avoid fraud. During a short speech, the Secretary General of the Prime Minister, Mr. Naguib Abdullah Kamil, expressed the importance of the meeting, but it allows that the state have to accord and reliable data to avoid fraud. On the agenda, he said, we integrated between portal and citizens the issue of data protections, the development of innovative services within the administration, but also the need of centralized services which require interactions between department and preparation of strategy to harmonize this approach that is to be put in place very soon. The chief of the general staff of the army, General Zakaria Sheikh Ibrahim, received at the hotel of officials Mr. Alexander, representative of the Russian state group Rostec, based in the Federal Democratic Republic of Ethiopia. Mr. Alexander was accompanied by Mikhail Klavanov, ambassador of Russian Federations of the Republic of Djibouti. For his part, General Zakaria Sheikh Ibrahim was assisted by the Brigadier General Tahir Ali Mohammed, as well as Chief of Defense Staff Colonel Mohammed Qayyad, Deputy Chief of Defense Colonel Mustafa Ali Handouli, as well as advisor to the Prison on Defense Colonel Omar Wa'is Bokore, Commander of the Coast Guard, and some official of the Army Forces staff. Indeed, as part of the ADF rises to power and strengthening of its mobility, the military command has decided to purchase 150 URL all-terrain trucks for the transport of soldiers. These troop transport vehicles meet international standard and are particularly suited to our mountainous environment. And now let's move on continental news, especially in Brazil, where the team near perfect record could see them qualify for 2022 FIFA World Cup in Qatar after their next game at home to Colombia tonight, before a far more perilous trip to Argentina 5 days later, with one game less than their South American rival. Brazil and Argentina are still unbeaten and are dominating this qualifying campaign. Here arrive the end of this news edition. Thank you for watching us. Goodbye.